can I say that I love the Lord, whom I've never ever seen before, and forget to say that I love the one whom I walk beside each and every day? How can I look upon your face and ignore God's love? You I must embrace. You're my brother, you're my sister, and I love you with the love of my Lord. How can I say that I love the Lord, whom I've never ever seen before, and forget to say love? You I must embrace. You're my brother, you're my sister, and I love you with the love of my Lord, love of my Lord. Well,
good morning. It sure is good to see you. If you read your bulletin, you'll see that I am not Dr. Bob Moon, but I've stayed in a Holiday Inn Express. It worked at 8:45. I thought I'd try it again at 11. It's good to see you all. We are in a series called Committed, and we're talking about the commitments we make as we join the church, and we'll be talking about the commitment for our presence later on this morning. But we are so glad that you're here today on this very special day when we remember those who have gone before us in the past year. This is All Saints Day, and we'll also be celebrating Holy Communion together in just a little while. But we're so glad that you are here this morning. Would you stand and let's sing together hymn number 702, Sing with All the Saints in Glory.
Thank you. sorry. I wanted to make one quick announcement. On the screen here, the Caring Christmas Tree ornaments, it said that they will be available next Sunday. Not correct. They will be available on the 20th. Marcia has asked that I make sure everybody knows that. So Caring Christmas Trees will be available here November 20th. Okay, please join me for the invitation to communion. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. Let's stand and greet each other in Christian love.
Good morning to all of you. We invite you to sing with uplifted voices, Marching to Zion.
Say a few words of thanks. It's amazing the response we had last week with the Kairos opportunity we gave to our all four of our worship services. Over about $4,600 were given last week, which I believe, if I remember correctly, Bart, it's about $4,000 to put a weekend on, or is that right?
That's right.
Okay. So we had an amazing response, and they are out there this weekend right now ministering to the men. And so if you remember them in your prayers, and for all those delicious chocolate chip cookies that were made. We thank you for those too. We didn't eat it. We ate the ones that didn't make the cut in the office, so we got some of those. But would you pray with me as we go to the Lord in prayer? Father, what a privilege it is to be a part of your work in the world. We get to partner with you. God, I pray now as we return our gifts, as we remember this time, whether we're actually putting something in the plate or we've already done it on the computer at home, Father, it's about our heart's desire to partner with you in ministry, and we pray your blessing on these gifts, that they would be used in such a magnificent way that if we tried to do it on our own, we'd fall so short. We thank you. We get to partner with you in ministry to the world. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. thank you so much, choir, for and Miss Betty, for leading us in that. So, as I mentioned when I said good morning a few moments ago, we are in this second week of this series where we're looking at the commitments that you made as members of the church. When we look at the decision you made when you said yes, if you're a member of the church right now, you might not remember, but you were asked a question, and it was, will you support the ministries of the church by your prayers, by your presence, by your service, by your witness, and by your gifts? And so last week we talked about the prayers, the importance of prayers. And today we want to look at what presence really means, what it looks like. And today, on this particular day, when we think about those who have passed from this life and gone on in glory to the next, we are reminded of presence. We're reminded of the power of presence. We think about these names that are there in your bulletin, and they're not just names on a sheet of paper. They are rich lives that have impacted generations of people. And we think about how their presence is most certainly missed today. We think about how their presence made our lives fuller. We think about how their presence enriched the lives of those that loved them, that those that came in contact with them. Because presence is such a very powerful thing. Presence is so very powerful. So when we say, will you support the ministries of the church by your presence, it's not just about showing up and checking an attendance sheet. No, it's so much more than that, and I want us to look at that together today because presence is so very powerful. I was thinking about that, this being the month of November, my mother passed last November 16th, and I think of her often. I was telling someone the other day that I was putting something in the oven, I don't know what it was, and I had that momentary thought of, I'm going to call Mom and remember the temperature that you're supposed to put this on. Just that, and then she's not here. And I've thought about that, and I thought about how her presence has been such a blessing to my life. Her presence was such a blessing to my life. As a mom of a five-year-old, I think about often how my mother, her presence was so important to me now that I am a mother. But I have to confess to you, I've often, especially recently, thought about the opportunities I had to be present in her life that I missed. Living so far away, living in a different state, even the phone calls I could have made or the letters and notes I could have written. Because presence is so powerful. And so I'm mourning the opportunities that I could have been more present with her. Presence is so very powerful. It's most certainly true with our friends, with our loved ones, with our spiritual family, with the church, with our local church. Our presence is very important. This is what you said, what you agreed to in regard to when you said, I will or I do, to your presence. Because see, a member of the church supports the church by faithfully participating in its ministries by their presence. It's hard to be faithful and not be present. It's hard to be faithful in our friendships and not be present. It's hard to be faithful in a marriage and not be present. It's hard to be faithful and not be present. So it's so very important that we're faithfully participating. We made this commitment to one another as we stood before the church and we said yes. And when we said yes to these questions about membership, prayers, presence, gifts, service, witness, we weren't saying, you know, I'm just going to join this organization. It's an organization, they meet down on the corner of Patterson and Valley. It's been there a really long time. I'm going to join it. That's not what we were saying yes to. No, we were saying, yes, we want to partner in ministry with other Christ followers because we want to be about the work of Jesus. I mean, there's no way that $4,600 could have been raised last week unless we all said, I want to be a part of this. I mean, a lot of people participated in that. We come into this together. We're part of a ministry together, not just a member of an organization. So when we say yes to our presence, it's not just about the showing up, but let's be honest, showing up is important. I mean, you do need to show up. In Hebrews, Paul was writing, and he said this about the church. He said in chapter 10, verse 25, don't give up the habit of meeting together as some have already done. See, already back in the first century church, they were already having a problem with people not showing up. And Paul's saying, no, show up. It's important to show up. It's important to make the time. It's important to put this as a priority in your life. It is important to show up. But what I want us to look at together this morning is just one verse, just one verse in John that I think gives us the definition, the understanding of what it means to truly be present, of what it looks like to truly be present as members of a church, as followers of Jesus. What does it look like to be present? Because what? Presence is really important. Presence is very powerful. Have you ever walked into a room expecting to see someone and they weren't there? You felt their absence. You ever gone somewhere and expected to see a group of people there? You know, what if you were the only one that set your clock back? Everyone else came here at 10 and they all said, well, let's just go to brunch. And you walked in here today and you would feel the absence of no one else being here. So you feel the absence because presence is so powerful. So yes, it's important to show up. It's important to make this investment of time and energy. But here's what it looks like to be present in the body of Christ. Jesus gives us the example. He says in John chapter 1, verse 14, just the first part of the verse, he says this, so the Word became human. You might notice, so the Word became flesh and made his home among us. Jesus knows what it's like to be present. He gave us the example of presence. He showed up. He showed up with skin and bones and lungs, and he drew in air and he exhaled and his heart would beat and his stomach would growl when he was hungry. Jesus showed up like you and me. He's no longer a God that was far off and you couldn't see or touch. He showed up. Jesus gives us an example of what it means to be present. He was physically present for us. But then, the rest of this verse, it says this, he was full of unfailing love and faithfulness. So he didn't just show up and be like, I'm way too holy for you people, so I'm going to stand over here. You just keep doing your little human thing, but I'm really... No, he was present and he was full of unfailing love and faithfulness. He was really present. He was there. He came amongst us in the pain and loneliness and weakness and confusion that all of us know in our frailty as humans. He shows up in that way. He shows up, and he shows up with faithfulness, and he shows up with unfailing love toward us. Jesus gives us the example of what it means to really be present, to truly be present. He showed up. This is how you and I can live out our commitment of presence. Because when we show up in faithfulness, when we show up in unfailing love, God can work through us in amazing ways. See, when you said, yes, I will, prayers, presence, gifts, service, and witness. When you said yes to that, I hope what you didn't mean is, well, I've just now joined an organization and I'm done. I hope that you didn't mean, well, I'm going to show up there and I'm just going to keep an eye on some people. No, I hope that what you said was, I am a part of this ministry. I am a part of the work of God, and He has me right now in Valdosta, Georgia, and I've chosen to partner with these people. And so I'm going to show up with faithfulness and with unfailing love, just like Jesus did. See, this is what it looks like to truly be present. This is what it looks like to do what Jesus did. We are being present in the lives of others. And I want you to hear this. I think you already are, but You know, of all the great stories we read about Jesus, when you open up your Bible and you read about the things Jesus did and the things that Jesus said, you know, most of those things happened outside of the worship services. Just about all of them. See, Jesus showed up and he participated in worship. He participated in the holy ceremonies of the church. He was there. He participated. But when we read about Jesus showing up, he also was showing up when he was walking on a road or having a conversation with somebody or eating a meal. He showed up in those places too. And what I would like you to hear today is it's not just about, well, there's the pastor up there talking about, I better show up, I better be here. This isn't about attendance. This is about looking at what Jesus did and saying, how can I do this? So we do need to show up. We need to support one another. We need to support the ministries of this church. But we also need to show up everywhere else too, just like Jesus did. He didn't turn it on and off. Jesus wasn't just faithful at worship. He wasn't full of unfailing love just whenever that was a special, you know, religious holiday. No, he was always showing up, and he was full of unfailing love and faithfulness. And there's this perfect example for us in John chapter 1, verse 14, for you to go and look at again and again and again and go, okay, I want to do this. This is how I want to be present. I want to be present in the lives of my church family. I want to be present in the lives of my family for however long God has me with them. I want to be present. I want to be full of faithfulness and unfailing love. And I even want to show up for maybe some of the people that I don't really get along with. Maybe there's some people that God has brought into your life and it's kind of hard right now. There's some rough edges and I'm sure they're the stubborn one and they're the one with the problem. But maybe God wants you to show up and be present in that relationship and in that connection, full of unfailing love and the faithfulness of Jesus Christ. He gives us this example. So when you said, yes, I'll be present, I hope today you are reminded of what you said. I hope today that you are maybe encouraged to, maybe the definition has broadened a bit. But Jesus gives us this example to be fully present in every aspect of our life. And that's what it means for us to fully participate in the ministries of the church, for us to show up, be fully engaged, and present this love and faithfulness of God to everyone around us. Would you pray with me? Father, I thank you that you give us the example through your Son, Jesus Christ. There is no better example. There just isn't. And I pray, Lord, that we would see today how much bigger your definition of our faith journey really is. Maybe we've made it small. Maybe we've made our relationship with you tiny. Maybe we've made it about just showing up attendance-wise at a worship service. Maybe we've made it just about loving those that are easy to love. Father, I pray today that you would expand our definition of what it looks like to be your follower. And I pray also that we would see that definition, that Jesus, that example Jesus has given us, and we would choose to take that on for ourselves. Because presence is such a powerful thing. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. And now as we turn towards our time of communion and remembering those who have gone before us, I ask that you would turn to page 13. To participate in the Great Thanksgiving, it will also be on the screens. Be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, God of Abraham and Sarah, God of Miriam and Moses, God of Joshua and Deborah, God of Ruth and David, God of the priests and the prophets, God of Mary and Joseph, God of the apostles and the martyrs, God of our mothers and our fathers, God of our children to all generations. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. Renew our communion with all your saints, especially those whom we name before you now. And I would ask that family members would stand as their loved one's name is read. Prentice D. Adams, Jr. William Broadfoot, Jr. Jerry A. Bozeman. Sanford B. Campbell. John E. Cookson. Helen M. Gamble. Jefferson W. Hunt. Jason L. Metters. Rachel B. C. Russell. Jesse J. Sedgwick. Dorothy J. Sedgwick. Miss Irma Lou Sherwood. John W. Thomas. Sydney A. Walker. Since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, strengthen us to run with perseverance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, if you will turn with me to our prayer of humble access on page 30. It also will be found on the screens. We do not presume to come to this, thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, So partake of this sacrament of thy Son, Jesus Christ, that we may walk in newness of life, may grow into his likeness, and may dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. I'll ask those who are serving if they would come and join me here before the table. And as I serve those who are about to serve you, I would ask that you would just take a few moments in silent prayer and preparation to come and receive. After we serve the choir, we'll ask that you will come to the outside of the rows, and you will come this way, and I'm sure the ushers will be happy to give direction where it is needed. Let's all stand and sing together, One Bread, One Body, hymn number 620. Would you take the hand of someone nearby you, and would you receive this benediction? Lord, we thank you that we get to partner with you in ministry in the world, and we thank you for the example of your Son, Jesus. And now, as your people, we will go out and we will be full of your unfailing love and your faithfulness for the glory of your Son. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. I'm well. How are you? Good to see you. Well, thank you.